Okay, Fakes Race 1 of the day. We have the saloons out on track there at the moment, and I must make very, very special mention, car number 38, James Stronach, celebrating a birthday today. So car 38, James Stronach, celebrating the birthdays. If you see him wandering around the pits, go up, shake his hand, wish him all the best. I have been told I am not allowed to mention how old he is. So put it this way, it's a little bit more than the number on the side of his car. All right? So a very, very happy birthday to James. Out there at the moment, car number 22, that is the Chevy Monza of Dan Black. Just on the outside of him, 21D Scott Helm. Second row of the grid, car 38. We just spoke about the man. It is his birthday today, James Stronach. Car 69, that is Ewan Shearing. A big thank you to Ewan for lending us all the gear last night to sort the track out and get it sorted today. Here's car 69, car number 47. The Cleanways machine of Lloyd Phillips. And we go back to car 66, which is Trevor Black. Car 21, Graham Williamson and the Hypermac. Car 68 is Dean Shearing, the Dean Shearing contracting sponsored machine. And just coming out the gate there at the moment, car 57, that is Clark Brown. That is the saloons ready to go for race number one here at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. Ready to go, race one. Dan Black leads him off. Alongside him, we've got Scott Helm side by side. Helm tries to go around the outside of Black. Looks like he's going to get the job done. Then there's Stronach, Clark Brown there as well. Lloyd Phillips wasting absolutely no time. He's picked himself up a couple of spots already. He's up into that fourth position just ahead of Stronach. Then we go back to Ewan Shearing, Graham Williamson there as well. Then we go to Trevor Black and Dean Shearing. But out in front at the moment from Dunedin, it's car 21, which is Scott Helm. Low bit of contact there between Stronach and Clark Brown. Cars behind taking drastic action as well. Lloyd Phillips, he takes advantage of that and he sneaks a couple of spots. He's currently up to second place in that Hypermac. Still Scott Helm though at the moment leads them around. Lloyd Phillips trying to make inroads onto the lead that Helm's pulled out already. Probably half a dozen car lengths between them. Graham Williamson, he's had enough for this one. He's gone to the infield, as is Trevor Black. And Clark Brown, a wee issue there between those three. But Helm leads them around. Lloyd Phillips, he's probably picked himself up a couple of car lengths there. He's not too much between those two now, first and second. Dan Black doing a good job on the wee Monza there in third place. He's got Stronach all over his back bumper, so a good battle happening there. Also the Shearings, cars 69 and 68, in their own little battle. That's the battle back there for fifth and sixth place. Helm leads him around one more time. Lloyd Phillips still not managing to make inroads on him at the moment. Lloyd will be trying to do everything he can to get around the outside of Helm. He's pushing that Hypermac Corvette pretty hard at the moment. Looks for the inside line. He's right on the back bumper of Helm, almost contact there. Phillips, as I said, he's done a lot of racing over the past wee while in the North Island, and he's certainly run plenty of panels. You can tell that by the side of his car. And he's come back to Riverside and he means business, but at the moment he can't seem to find a way around car 21. Helm still third place. Dan Black just managing to hold off the birthday boy. James Stroud. Black goes around, so he's handed it to Stronach. Might be a bit of a birthday gift for him. He's given it to Stronach, so there we go. Position change. He's up into third place. Last lap flag is out. Helm still leads this one here. Oh, Lloyd Phillips very, very sideways into one. That's cost him some ground. Helm manages to stretch legs on the back straight. He's got a good lead now over Lloyd Phillips. He looks comfortable. Looks like he's going to take out race number one at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. Scott Helm from Dunedin takes it out. Lloyd Phillips second. Then we go back to Stronach. Good drive there in the end by Stronach. Ewan Shearing takes out fourth. Then Dean Shearing fifth. Then we go back to Dan Black and Trevor Black. So there we go, folks. Race number one of the evening. Taken out by this man here, number 21D, the Fresh Fish Shop sponsored machine of Scott Helm. Good drive. Of obviously issues there for the Graham Williams and X-Factor cars. Mustang parked up in the centre there. Disappointing after the good night they had last night, but I'm sure Graham will be back to fight another day. Come race two a wee bit later on this afternoon. Stick around, folks. Hope you're enjoying the sunshine. Youth Saloons are going to be out on track next. So Youth Saloons about to hit the track now, ladies and gentlemen. Of course, these guys here are the future stars of Speedway. Without these guys here, we wouldn't have likes of the Alf Cup happening and the drivers going up through the grades. So great to see these young up-and-coming drivers out there. You can race these cars from the age of 12 years old right through to the age of 16. So if you've got kids out there who think they're pretty handy behind the wheel, do come over and see the grade rep from the Youth Saloon grade. Very, very cheap sport to get into, and a good bunch of kids to be fair as well. And we're actually looking for a little bit of help. We've got a young driver who's just started this year, Nathan Rind. He's got a wee Honda Civic, sort of late 80s, early 90s, I guess, and he needs a new engine for that. So if anyone out in the audience here knows of an engine for that little Honda Civic, please come over and see us, and we'll pass your details on to Nathan. Be great to see him back on track here and get that car sorted. He's just having a wee bit of trouble finding a new race engine for that there. So if you can help us out, folks, come on over and see us. So Youth Saloon's out on track at the moment, leading them out that super quick yellow COX. One man to watch, that is Jack Brown, sponsored by Sam Brown Concrete Cutting. Alongside him, car number 28, Georgia Gordon. Second row of the group, car number 21, Olivia Beck. Graham lines up beside 88, Zane Tahuna. Then we go back to 43, Luke Malloy, who lines up beside 16, Acacia Mitchell. 22, Jacob Garrick, certainly one to watch out for. He's been pretty quick this season as well. Then we go to 44, Anastasia Labrook. Then number 15, Emma Phillips, 77, Emma Gordon. And at the back of the field there, car 888 is Jacob McIntyre. Jacob's first meeting here at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway was last night. He's on the mentoring program, so he's got to start from the rear of the field. This is what happens with these Youth Saloons. And he's pretty much just got to get some laps under his belt. He's got to drive around and sort of sit in behind the cars until he's ready to, until the officials are satisfied that he's ready to start getting in amongst it. Georgia Gordon lead them around. Should get a start this time. Race two tonight at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. We're underway. Brown gets a good start. Gordon's right beside him though as they head down the main straight. Keep an eye on the bright green machine of Beck Graham. She slips into third place. Gets around the outside of Tahuna, but look at car 22. That is Jacob Garrick. He's moved up into that fourth spot already, challenging for third. He's gone out wide. Looks like he's getting plenty of drive out there as he heads around the outside of Beck Graham. That's for third and fourth at the moment. Then we go back to car 15, Emma Phillips, Acacia Mitchell there as well. Then Luke Malloy, Ladbrook, Gordon, and Jacob McIntyre. So Jack Brown got a good wee lead there at the moment. Check out Garrick. Garrick's wee car. He looks absolutely on fire there tonight. He's moved up into second place at the moment. Looks like he's making inroads on young Jack Brown as well. Looking very racy. Heads to the inside line. The Southern Pawnbrokers machine is half a car length between 157 and 22 for the lead of the race. Look at Garrick. He sits in behind him. Heads to the outside. He's going to have a go at Jack Brown. No one's done this all season. Brown's had all his own way, but he's going to have his handful in just a moment with car 22, Jacob Garrick. Garrick just goes a little bit wide there. Brown manages just to stretch the legs a little bit. We go back to third place. Zane Tahuna goes around the outside of Gordon. Beck Graham's there as well. Good battle for third, fourth, and fifth spot at the moment. Round comes Brown and Garrick. Wee bit of lap traffic in front of them, the likes of McIntyre and Gordon. So Brown does the right option, heads to the outside. So does Garrick. Through they go. No issues here whatsoever. So Herta starting to find some pace as well in car number 88. He's in that third spot. Fourth, we go back to Beck Graham. Then Gordon, car number 28. Phillips, car 15. Mitchell, 16. And Luke Malloy, car 43. So at the moment, it is still a 1-5-7. Jack Brown, who leads him around, probably a car length and a half now over young Jacob Garrick. Not a whole lot between them. Onto the main straight, Garrick looks like he's picked up that inside line now. He just needs to get a little bit closer. Look at this, he almost gets a front bumper underneath the back wheel there of Brown. Not quite close enough, but he's still holding the inside line. Zane Tahuna, he's catching these guys relatively quickly at the moment as well. Garrick changes his line once again, heads to the outside this time. Has a go at Brown on the main straight. Can he get around him this time? There's one lap to go here at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. Race one for the evening in the Youth Saloons. Garrick's doing everything he can to get around the outside of Brown. It's a horsepower race on the back straight. Garrick's on the outside of him. Can he hold him as they come around? Brown still just managing to hold him off. Tahuta's there as well. And checkered flag is going to come out. Oh, I hate to call it, but I think it may have been Brown just ahead. Looks like Jack Brown may have just got it. Over car 22, Jacob Garrick, who put a ton of pressure on the back of Brown. Good drive there by young Zane Tahuta as well. Car 88 looking racy in the second half of that race. Once he got through that slower traffic, he was pretty quick. Fifth we'd give to Emma Phillips by the looks of it. But no, checkered flag has been presented. Car number 22, folks, put your hands together. Not too many people can knock off Jack Brown, car 157, but young Jacob Garrick, he's managed to do it. So congratulations, Jacob Garrick, Southern Pawnbrokers, New Zealand Courier-sponsored machine. So Goodfield of Street Stocks out on track there at the moment, leading them out, car 27, which is Peter Knight. He lines up alongside a 19 from Dunedin, which is Jamie Lott. Second row of the grid, Mark Henderson, car number 34, will line up beside car 83, Megan Malloy. Then we go back to car 52, Graham Morris, another visitor from Dunedin. Great to see the Dunedin guys down here supporting us. 61 is Scott Ashton. Then we go back to car number 66, Charles Corkery. He lines up alongside last night's epic roller, Simon Elliott in car 9. Then at the back of the grid, Lachlan McCain, car 43. Samuel Bennett-Cathro, car 47D. And the current South Island champion, car number 7, Paul Simon, will start in the back row of the grid there as well. Good field of Street Stocks. They turned on a bit of action here for us last night with a small field. Looking forward to this one here. We're in the starters' hands, folks. Peter Knight leads him off. Megan Malloy in second place. Look at that. Mark Henderson, he's wedged in behind those two Dunedin cars. They're playing a wee bit of team tactics here. They're holding Mark Henderson in. Henderson won't like that there. I'm sure payback will be on the mind of Mark Henderson already. Round goes, got a couple of the Dunedin boys taking each other out. That's car 61, Scott Ashton and Samuel Bennett-Cathro. But at the moment, Peter Knight leads him around. Megan Malloy there in that second spot. Then we go back to Scott Ashton. Cockery's there as well. Paul Simon, he manages to sneak down the inside of the big wagon, Samuel Bennett-Cathro. But it's Peter Knight at the moment. He's got his hands full of Megan Malloy there. There's probably only half a car length between the two of them. Car number 66 gone to the infield already. That's Charles Gockery, so we got issues for him. Just a second meeting here at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway tonight. Third place at the moment, car 61, Scott Ashton. Then we go back to car 7, Paul Simon in that fourth spot. 47, Bennett-Cathro. Car number 19, Jamie Lott, and Mark Henderson pushing pretty hard after he was held up at the start there. Don't know if there's issues for car number 52, Graham Morris, or not, or whether he's just sitting around waiting for these leaders to go round. Always a little bit of team tactics happening in this street stock grade. The leader's about to go past him now, so yeah, there's certainly no issues there for car 52. He's just trying to make a bit of a nuisance of himself. Simon Elliott takes care of him, he spins him. Elliott's round as well, so Elliott certainly would have helped Peter Knight and Megan Malloy there, because car 52, Graham Morris, he certainly had them in their sights. That was his target. Oh, big spin there. Another two Dunedin boys. That's car number 19, Jamie Lott. And looks like Bennett-Cathro coming together. Car number 42 coming through there now as well. 43, sorry, that's Lachlan McLean. Paul Simon starting to make a bit of a move for that second spot now as well. He's on the inside line of Megan Malloy, pushing pretty hard. He's got the best line as they head down into turn one and two. Peter Knight still leads this one though. Still action at the top end of the track there. These Dunedin boys certainly taking each other out this afternoon. Bennett Cathro gets a little bit sideways there, heading into the final turn. Doesn't take anyone out though. Look at this car, 52. He's all over his own driver, Paul Simon, as Megan Malloy heads around the outside. She takes advantage of that, moves up into that second spot. Oh, she gets an absolute drilling from Graham Morris. Checker flag is going to come out this time around though. Looks like it's going to be Peter Knight. He'll claim victory here in race number one for the Street Stocks. He'll be followed home by car seven, Paul Simon. Not entirely sure who got third. It was Megan Malloy, but Malloy, of course, she got spun. Mark Henderson may well have been the next one home after being held up at the start. We'll wait and see, but if this first race is anything to go by, I'd say there's going to be plenty of action, plenty of payback to come in the Street Stocks as the afternoon goes on. But congratulations, Peter Knight, the Autotech tuning machine. He takes out race number one here in the Street Stocks. Hope you're enjoying the action, folks. Mini Stocks, they're out on track in just a moment. Mini Sprint, sorry. Race number one of the evening for the Modified Sprints. Don't forget the next meeting here at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway taking place Saturday the 13th of February. It is the ITM Modified Sprints. This promises to be an absolutely massive meeting. There'll be a lot of cars coming down from the Christchurch region and should be, an absolutely fantastic race meeting for the Modified Sprints. Big field of them. Make sure you head along to that one there, mark it on your calendar, Saturday the 13th of February. Some modified sprints out on track at the moment. Car 23 is Tony Jones, the Grant Auto Electrical Single Design Speedmart Machine. He's going to line up beside car 11, Darcy Hewitt, sponsored by K&D Automotive and X-Factor Cars. Second row of the grid, 6i, which is Kobe Morrison, sponsored by Riverton Freight and Milne's Transport. Chris Sharp will line up beside him. Car 43, Chris Sharp, sponsored by Transport Engineering Southland, Creation Signs and Civrite. Then we go back to the third row of the grid. We see car 99, George Phillips, sponsored by Cleanway and Southern Mechanical. 84 there, brand new car for this man, Jason McMullen. He won the race last night. He's sponsored by K&D Automotive. And at the back of the field, Tim Wilson, car number 18, sponsored by Waipunamu and Waiamea Contracting. He was a street stock driver, now he's decided to head into the modified sprints. This is his second race in this here. He did the first race last night. This is his second race in the modified sprints. We must all... Looks like modified sprints are ready to get underway. Chris Sharp moves across there. He moves into that third position pretty quickly indeed. Car number 23 leads them around though. That is Tony Jones. He goes back to Hewitt. Then we've got Chris Sharp and car 84, Jason McMullen, who's come from a row back to get up into that fourth spot nice and early. Oh, around we go. That's car number 18. Tim Wilson does a bit of a donut for us at the top end of the course, but he's back up and running. He'll be used to that if he's a street stock driver. So at the moment, we've got Jones. We go back to Hewitt, Sharp, McMullen, Phillips. Kobe Morrison getting a wee bit loose there as well. Very loose indeed. He goes around, heads to the infield. And then we've got Wilson. Jones looking pretty racy at the moment. Car number 23, the Grand Auto Electrical Singleton Signs car. He heads them around. Darcy Hewitt doing a great job there in the K&Z Automotive. Sponsored car number 11. Chris Sharpie starting to come under a ton of pressure there from McMullen. Phillips is joining that group as well. That's your battle for third, fourth and fifth spot there at the moment. Then we go back to Wilson and Kobe Morrison at the rear of the field. At the moment, though, it's still car 23 leading them around. Darcy Hewitt trying to make inroads on that lead. There's probably three or four lengths between them. Hewitt looks to be making up a wee bit of time as they get into the corners. Chris Sharp, he sits back there in that third position there at the moment. He's managed to shake off McMillan. But McMillan, he's got his hands full of George Phillips. Phillips goes underneath him. He loses another spot, so he's gone back into that fifth place, car number 84. Kobe Morrison finding issues again. He's filled into the infield there. It's Morrison's race, done and dusted. Still out in front at the moment. Only a couple of car lengths between the two of them. It's car 23. Tony Jones just managing to hold off Darcy Hewitt in that second spot. Phillips starting to look quite racy as this race goes on. Yellow flag is out. McMullen, he spins. Does it all on his own. The track just a little bit slick for these guys. It's a new car, as we said earlier on, for Jason McMullen. He'll be getting the hang of it, getting used to the setup of it, and he just overdid it as he came into turn one and two. We're underway. Jones leads them off. Then we go back to Hewitt. Chris Sharp there as well. Then we've got Phillips, McMullen. Oh, Phillips is under the inside of Sharp. He gets the pass made, sits on the inside. So Sharp slips back into that fourth spot. As I said before, folks, keep an eye on car 99. He's found plenty of speed in the later stages of this race. He's got Hewitt just in front of him. Hewitt trying to ping him off as well. Car 99. He's in third place at the moment, but the man out in front, he's managed to extend his lead while this battle goes on behind him. That is Tony Jones. Last lap flag is out for Jones. One more to go for him. Darcy Hewitt's there. George Phillips trying to do everything he can to pick up another spot. He'd like to take that second spot. At the moment, Hewitt defends on the back straight. Phillips has a look underneath. Phillips has a dive. He's moved up into second. Checkered flag is out. Tony Jones is going to take it. Phillips will settle for second. Then we go back to Darcy Hewitt, Chris Sharp, McMullen, and Tim Wilson. So as I said, folks, 99, he was the man to watch out for. And he was super fast towards the end of that race there. Race number one for the evening for the modified sprints. Good run there from Darcy Hewitt. Third place. Chris Sharp in fourth. Then we go back to McMullen. And car number 18, Tim Wilson. There we go, folks. Tony Jones picks himself up. I think it's his first win for the season here at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. He's put a lot of work into that car, a lot of time and effort. Looks like it's certainly paid off. Can tell you, folks, next race coming up is heat number one, the Southland Championship for the Creativity Plus Production Saloons. The way they are running this tonight, they've done a marble draw for the first race. They will do reverse order of that for the second race. And their overall points will decide the grid for the third race. And the winner of that race will be the Southland champ. So it's a winner takes all race, the third one this afternoon. And the title is vacant. Dylan Mountney is the current Southland champion of this grade. And he's not here racing tonight, so the championship is vacant. We're going to be crowning a new Southland champion here tonight in the production saloons. So, folks, good field of Creativity Plus production saloons out on track at the moment, leading them out. Car number 45, Trev Uran. He's been a member of the Rock FM Riverside Speedway crew here for a number of years. He leads them out. He lines up along car number 38, Shannara Stronach. Second row of the grid, keep an eye on this guy here, young Tam Clements in the Toyota Celica. He's been pretty racy all season. 52 from Cromwell. Jeff Friend lines up in fourth spot on the grid. Then we go back to the third row of the grid, Shay Davey. He lines up beside a man who has been pretty dominant here the last couple of meetings. Car 99 from the Cromwell track, Fetu Tawa, keep an eye on him in the Subaru. Then we go to car 44, Shane Carson, the Commodore from Dunedin. Owen Osborne lines up car number 47. Alongside him, car number 68, Luke Oliver. Then we go to 72, which is Jesse Stevens in the Mitsubishi. 36i, Grant Meekle, the wee green manster. Outside of him, car number 26, Asher Clements. And right at the back of the field there, Dave Horton. Keep an eye out for him. He'll be wanting to come through the field. He's been pretty quick all season. And just in behind, Dave Carr, number 12, Michaela Livingston, good field of Production Saloons, ready to battle it out for the Southland Production Saloon Championship. We're underway, you're in lead, Simon. Stronach cheats it to the outside. Look at Tam Clements and Jeffrey, and they thread the needle. They go right through the middle there. Tam Clements making every post a winner already. He's off to a great start. Fetutawa, keep an eye on him. He's up to third place already. Gets a wee bit loose. He's to the inside line. Almost went over the pole line there in turn three. But at the moment, the Invercargill Tractor Servicing and Repairs Toyota Celica of Tam Clements is out in front. He's got the foot hard up this beast. Car number 45 in second place. Trevor, oh, big contact with the wall there. That's Sonara Stronic. She hits the wall coming out of two. Got a wee bit loose there. Don't know whether she's just going to limp around or whether or not she's going to pull up lame on the backside of the track there. Hopefully she can get to the infield. Doesn't look like she's going to, so I'd imagine we're going to get a yellow. Yes, we do. Yellow light is on, so Tam Clements, he'll be gutted. He's pulled himself out a decent lead there. And they're going to have to do it all over again. So as I say, Clements almost had the length of the straight lead. But he's going to have to do it all over again. 45, Trevor in, starting from the front of the pack. He's in second place, driving a good race at the moment. Then we go back to 99, Fetutawa, that's your top three. Another good drive there by Shea Davey Khan, number four. And Luke Oliver moving through the pack as well. I've seen he had a wee bit of contact coming out of turn two as well. So it's going to be an interesting battle from the restart. So we're underway, the restart here, the Southland Championship for Production Saloons. And look at car number 68. That is Luke Oliver. He goes around the outside of Fetutawa, but that man out in front at the moment, he's managed to just extend that lead slightly. That is young Tam Clements, number 99, Fetutawa, having a tough job getting around. Trevor, you're in there at the moment, so it's managing Clements to extend that lead. Luke Oliver heads right down the outside on the main straight there. He's going to move up into that second spot. Uren might just hold him out though, so he slips back to third place. Then we go back to Tawa, Shea Davey there as well, 52, Jeff Friend. Then back to Asher Clements, 44, Shane Carson, and number 5, Dave Horton, starting to make a few positions up through the field as we speak. Second place now, car number 68, Luke Oliver. He just gets around the outside of Trevor Uren, gets the job done, so he's comfortably in second. And he's got Tam Clements in his side. He'll have a foot hard down in this Nissan Primera. Fetutawa decides the outside line is the way to go. He's moved to the outside of Trevor Uren as well, but can he get around him? Shea Davey doing well in this one as well. He's currently holding that fifth position in car number 4. Looks like there's an issue for 36, Grant Meikle there as well. So Meikle just circulating around the outside of the track. Fetutawa tries once again to get around the outside of Trevor Uren. He's a wee bit further around this time. He might move up into that third spot, but Uren holds the pole line there. He makes Fetutawa have to work hard, but he gets the job done. So Tawa up into that third place. Race order at the moment, Tam Clements. The Invercargill Tractor Servicing and Repairs, Toyota Celica, leads them around. He's got a decent lead there at the moment. Car number 68 in second, Luke Oliver. He's getting chased pretty hard by Fetutawa, car number 99. He's your third spot. Shea Davey and Dave Horton starting to put a wee bit of pressure on car number 45 now. Trevor, you're in as well, but you're in still holding that fourth position. They all shoot past car number 36, Grant Meikle, who's circulating just on the outside of the track. White flag is out, folks. Less than one more lap to go for your race leader, car number 25, Tam Clements. Good battle happening back for fourth, fifth, and sixth. It's Uren, Davey, and Horton battling it out. Car number 44, Shane Carson, his day is over. Checkered flag is out. Tam Clements takes it out, banks maximum points in race number one. He's followed by Oliver. Tawa there in third place. Then I think we go back to Dave Horton, Trevor Uren, and Shea Davey. So a good drive by those guys as well. But a pretty commanding victory. Put your hands together, folks. He's just a young bloke. Celebrated a birthday this week as well. Cam Clements, of course, heat two is going to be a little bit harder for him. He's going to have to start from the rear of the field. Started off the front in that one there. Put your hands together, folks. Good victory. Tam Clements, the Invercargill Tractor Servicing and Repairs, Toyota Celica. So, folks, stock cars out on track there at the moment. Just a small field of them. You are looking for a cheap stock car. Dylan Mountney here has one for sale, going very, very cheap. He just wants to move it on. It's all been repainted and rebuilt, so it'll be a good wee car. There is good numbers of stock cars around in Southland at the moment, but just the four of them here today. As we mentioned earlier on, we're going to do a wee bit of teams racing in this one here. We're going to have Logan McNamara, car number 21, teaming up with car 29, Shannon Knight. And they're going up against car number 8, Aaron Borthwick, and car number 95, Andrew Watson, driving Irwin Trees car there as well. So Shannon Knight was talking himself up in the control tower here before, telling me it's the young guns against the old farts. We'll see how they go. Youth versus experience, teams racing in the stock cars here at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. Straight away, plenty of action. As Shannon Knight goes right around the outside of them, Andrew Watson, he puts paid to car number 21, which is Logan McNamara. He parks him on the infield with Aaron Borthwick. So Borthwick, he heads along the outside now. Andrew Watson's just waiting for car number 21. Looks like he's going to circulate and be the instigator tonight. I have been told that there is money up tonight for these guys too, for the best stirrer. So we'll wait and see who that's going to be. McNamara has a bit of a swipe at Andrew Watson. Watson just sits and waits for him. What's McNamara got for him? He gets right in behind car number 95 right now. Pushes to the inside, can't get anything done. Watson's just cruising around at the moment. Shannon Knight still leads this one here. Car number 29, he's on the back straight at the moment. McNamara doing a good job of holding Watson in there, so Knight manages to get past. Second place at the moment, car number 8, Aaron Borthwick. He's on the other side of the track compared to Shannon Knight. So it looks like Shannon's playing the role of the runner. 21, Logan McNamara, the job of the blocker. Whether or not that was planned before the race started, who would know? Andrew Watson back out on track now, car number 95. So we'll wait and see whether or not he sits back and waits for Shannon Knight. Obviously, if he can hold Knight up, it's going to put the victory into car number 8's hands, which is Aaron Borthwick. Fairly widespread at the moment, though, the stock cars. Shannon Knight still leads them around from car number 8, Aaron Borthwick. Then we go back to 21, Logan McNamara at 95. Andrew Watson. Watson starting to slow down there again. He probably knows that Shannon Knight's just in behind him. Keep an eye on car number 95. Shannon Knight's going to go right into the back of him. That's one thing I'll say about Shannon Knight, folks. Whether he's winning the race or not, he will just absolutely clobber you. And he just drilled Andrew Watson. So he still leads the race. Gotta love that guy's style, Shannon Knight. Still leads him around, but Andrew Watson, he's going to pull back onto the track. He'll know. No, I thought he might have got back out on track there to equal things up with Shannon Knight, but he waited for him to go past. White flag is out. Shannon Knight still leads this one here at the moment. Aaron Borthwick in that second place. He'll be about to head brown past his teammate Andrew Watson. Third at the moment, Logan McNamara. And fourth, car 95, Andrew Watson. Borthwick looks a wee bit nervous to actually get around his own teammate, so I don't know what's going on there. Maybe Andrew Watson's turned on him. Not sure. Borthwick gives him a bit of a nudge. They're meant to be teammates. There's not much teamwork going on there. Checkered flag is out. Shannon Knight takes it out. Followed by car 8, Aaron Borthwick, 21, Logan McNamara, and Andrew Watson will settle for that fourth spot. So as far as teams racing goes, it went to car 21, Logan McNamara, and 29, Shannon Knight. Stock cars will be out a little bit later on this afternoon. Get ready, folks, round number 2 of racing about to start next with the saloons. So into round two, a racing boat. Saloons out on track there at the moment for their second race of the night. Car number 69 leads them around. That is Ewan Shearing, sponsored by Ewan Shearing Contracting. On the outside of him, car number 47 is Lloyd Phillips. Graham Williamson obviously chucked another wheel on that machine. He had a puncher in race number one, so he's back out on deck. It looks like he's going to start from the second row of the grid. Car number 66 and behind him, Black Racing's Trevor Black. Then we go back to car number 68, Dean Shearing, the Dean Shearing Contracting machine. Alongside him is Dan Black and the wee Chevy Monza. Race one winner, Scott Helm from Dunedin, will start alongside. Birthday boy, 38, James Stronach from the rear of the pack, and he will start alongside car number 57, which is Clark Brown in the white Corvette right at the back of the grid. So should be a good wee battle up front there. Three very, very quick cars in the shape of Shearing, Phillips and Graham Williamson at the front end of the grid. Trevor Black certainly no slug either, so it's going to be a good wee battle up there. So it looks like we could be ready for a start this time around. Ewan Shearing leads him around alongside Lloyd Phillips, Graham Williamson in three. They are underway. Lloyd Phillips goes straight to the lead at the moment. That bonnet of his sticking up just slightly there. Probably some of the North Island damage that he suffered. Looks like the birthday boy, car number 38, James Stronach, getting a wee bit loose there in turn number one. Good to see he's back on track there though. Lloyd Phillips very, very high coming into three and four. But he manages to get back on track. He's leading them around at the moment. Oh, Shearing, in fact, has snuck underneath. Williamson almost sneaks under there as well. This car of Lloyd Phillips looking a little bit sick. He's wobbly as anything going down the back straight. Fishtailing down there. So Lloyd Phillips, the handling of car 47. Something not quite right there, folks. I wouldn't be surprised if we see him pull in. We'll wait and see. Still sticking it out there at the moment. So at the moment, car 69, Ewan Shearing leads him around. He's under a ton of pressure from the X-Factor Hypermac of Graham Williamson, who currently sits in second spot. Williamson sneaks down on the inside there, can't quite get through. Then we go back to Trevor Black, Dean Shearing there as well in that fourth spot, and Dan Black, Clark Brown, Lloyd Phillips there as well, Scott Helm, and at the back of the field, James Stronach. A lot of work to do for Lloyd Phillips if he wants to come back through the field, but that car of his looked very, very loose indeed. Looks like he's got it sorted now, though. Graham Williamson doing everything he can at the moment to get on that inside line. Looks like he's going to down here, but no, Ewan Shearing shuts the door. Graham Williamson sticks the nose of the Mustang on the inside. Might have been a little bit of contact there from Williamson as he went through, just a little racing incident. But he's taken over the lead of this one here. Shearing's pushing pretty hard on that back bumper of Graham Williamson, but Williamson's got the horsepower on the back straight. He puts the X-Factor Cars Hypermac Mustang out in front. Ewan Shearing in second place. Trev Black having a good drive at the moment. Car number 66 currently holding that third position. But watch out, Dean Shearing, he's up in the fourth now and he's trying to move through as well. He's a wee bit sideways, Dean Shearing there, loses a little bit of ground, keeps a foot hard up as he comes round turn two, manages to just hold out Dan Black. Clark Brown starting to play into this one here as well. He's all over the back of car 22. Lloyd Phillips and Scott Helm still in this battle also. Wee bit of contact just in front of the control tower between Trev Black and Ewan Shearing. Black does enough just to unsettle him. They're side by side on the back straight. Shearing still just managing to hold him out. Black pushing pretty hard for that second spot at the moment as Graham Williamson starts to drive away with this one here. Checkered flag is out. Williamson takes it. And massive rollover on the straight here. Damn Black. Upside down. Didn't see that one happen, so hopefully we see the replay up here. But that was a big rollover. I was too busy keeping an eye on Graham Williamson taking the checkered flag, wasn't even looking behind. But there is bits and pieces of saloons all over the track. Just looking at the Cando Fishing replay here, Dan Black looked like he was heading under the inside of Dean Shearing. Shearing got a little bit loose, Black just tapped the bonnet. Bitten and over he went. Just a bit of a soft rollover, but at speed it would have felt pretty terrifying inside the Monza there. So wee bit of contact between those two. The rest of the cars pretty much taking drastic action. Must thank the Cando Fishing team and Pitts Media, of course, for setting me up here with a replay screen up in the control tower so we can let you guys know what happened if we happen to miss it. Very handy indeed. Just watching the Cando Fishing replay up here in the control tower again, and it was shearing, just got a wee bit loose coming out of four. Black just clipped the front end of his car and over he went. Clark Brown, Scott Helm and Lloyd Phillips, they just took drastic action. No contact between those guys. The big contact was between Dean Shearing, who just got a little bit loose coming out of four, and Dan Black. So as I say, hopefully Dan Black's all right. The medic's just talking to him there at the moment. Good to see wee bit of rebuilding to do for Dan Black. He did have a big accident just a month or so ago up there in Cromwell at the Christmas racing up there. Had a fairly extensive rebuild there, and it looks like he's going to have a few more bits and pieces to fix. But there is your winner, ladies and gentlemen, Graham Williamson in the X-Factor Cars Mustang. Put your hands together, winner of race two for the Saloons here tonight at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. The round two of racing, race number two for the Youth Saloons tonight here at the Rock FM. Riverside Speedway car number 43 leads him around. That is Luke Malloy, sponsored by Nigel Malloy Joinery, Queenstown Carpet Court and Tiviot Street Autos. Alongside him, car number 44, Anastasia Labrick, sponsored by Iron Autos, first season here at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. Second row of the grid, race one, a winner, car number 22, Jacob Garrick will line up beside car 15, Emma Phillips. Then we go back to 77, Emma Gordon, who lines up beside 157, Jack Brown. 28 is Georgia Gordon, lining up beside 88, Zane Tahuta. Then we've got number 21, Olivia Beck Graham. We're underway. Luke Malloy leads him off. Ladbrook's there as well. Look at the start that Phillips and Brown got. Whoa, Phillips has gone around. Brown has gone into the wall. Mitchell's taken drastic action as well. I was going to say Phillips got picked up a ton of speed going into that first corner, and she couldn't quite hold on to the wee Honda Civic. Spun it around, so we'll have a restart, folks. Yellow is out. They both went to the outside of the track, both Phillips and Brown. Brown went into the wall. Phillips went very, very close to going into the wall. Managed to get back out on track though. Just looking at the Cando Fishing replay, yeah, bit of a nudge there for young Jack Brown. This is probably a wee bit of damage to the rear corner of his Honda CRX. He was just pretty much avoiding car number 15, Emma Phillips. That's 77, Emma Gordon lines up with 28, Georgia Gordon. We're underway once again. Oh, Garrick threads a needle, goes right through the middle of them. There was no room there at all. I'm sure he would have taken the door handles off had they had door handles. He went straight through the middle. He knew where he wanted to go. And look at the lead that he's built up there already. Car number 22. He won race one here. And he's making every post a winner at the moment. He leads Luke Malloy currently. He slips back to third place. Zane Tahuta goes around the outside of him, and that Honda Integra looking very, very quick at the moment as well. Then we go back to car number 15, which is Emma Phillips. Car 16 there as well. Acacia Mitchell sits in fifth spot at the moment. Then we've got Gordon, Labrook, Beck Graham. We go back to Gordon and car 888, Jacob McIntyre. Look at McIntyre. He just wants to go around the outside of Gordon, but he's on this mentoring program. And he's not meant to, but I bet he wants to. So out in front at the moment, Garrick, look at him, he's absolutely thrashing this machine on the back straight, but Zane Tahuta's catching him pretty quick. Tahuta's going to have a look on the inside at 3 and 4 here. This is your battle for first and second spot at the moment. Garrick very, very quick on the straights, but Tahuta seems to be that wee bit faster in the corners. He just needs to get underneath him, maybe push him out a wee bit wide, cause him to make a mistake, but at the moment he's not doing so. Luke Malloy doing a great job back there in that third position at the moment. He's in a good wee battle with Emma Phillips and the Cleanways machine, car number 15. Then we go back to Mitchell. Beck Graham just manages to pick up another spot as well from Georgia Gordon. Here comes Zane Tahuta. He's got himself on the inside of Garrick. Is Garrick going to leave the door open for him? They get on the straight. He's got a wee bit more power on the straight by the looks of it. Just manages to hold him out. Tahuta sticks a nose under. Garrick shuts the door. Lap traffic in front of them. He's got McIntyre and Gordon in front. Tahuta goes one way. Garrick goes the other. Tahuta decides, no, I'm going to head to the outside. Almost clips Gordon on the way through. So this has managed to get a wee bit of breathing space for Garrick, who's out in front at the moment. Three or four car lengths. Look at Tahuta. He's very fast as they come into turn three and four. He's looking for that inside line. Garrick's sitting in the middle of the track at the moment. We go back to third spot. Luke Malloy doing a fantastic job there in third place at the moment. He's only about 14 years of age, young Luke Malloy, doing a great job. Look at Tahuta. He's still waiting for Garrick just to leave that door open. Garrick doing a great job of defending first place at the moment. Tahuta's right up the inside of him, though, as they come past. White flag is out. What can Garrick do? Garrick shuts the door once again. Tahuta may have to change his line. He might get a wee bit of drive out of turn out of turns two and three. Out of turn two. Goes to the infield slightly. That's going to help Garrick. Garrick's just got one more turn to go. Round they come. Youth Saloon's checkered flag is out. Tahuta has a dive on the inside. Garrick's out in front. He's going to take it out. Two from two for Garrick. Zane Tahuta in second place. A good fight from Tahuta. Beck Graham, a great job to get up into that third spot. Then Malloy, Phillips, Mitchell, Gordon, and McIntyre. The checkered flag for second time tonight to young Jacob Garrick. He had to work for that one there. Zane Tahuta all over the back of him. But he got it done. That's race number two for the evening for the Youth Saloon. Stick around, folks. Heat number two of the Southland Super Saloon Championships. It's coming up next. Okay, race fans, three stocks out on track right now. There was plenty of carnage in race one earlier this evening with these guys here. I'm sure there's going to be plenty of payback to come. And this one here, leading them out, Simon Elliott, car number nine. He's parked up alongside car number 66, Charles Cookery. Just in behind him, car number seven, Paul Simon from Dunedin. Also 43, Lachlan McLean. 83 is Megan Malloy. She lines up alongside 52 from Dunedin, Graham Morris. Then we go back to race one, a winner, Peter Knight, car number 27. Couple of guys that caused plenty of headaches in race number one is car 19, Jamie Lott, and car 61, Scott Ashton, both of Dunedin. And beside them, Mark Henderson. He'll be looking for a little bit of payback, I would imagine, after they held him up there in race number one. And right at the back of the field, Samuel Bennett Cathro, the big Falcon station wagon. Looks like we're underway. Rolling start for the street stock. Simon Elliott almost. Oh, he gets a bit of a nudge on the main straight there. The steward on the infield takes drastic action, so he's moved to the infield already. Car 43, which is Lachlan McLean. He's into the back of Corkery. Oh, Megan Malloy gets a big nudge on the main straight from 52. Graham Morris, she got nailed by him in race number one as well. Certainly plenty of action happening at the back of the field here. These Dunedin boys know how to dish it out. Simon Elliott has a bit of a swipe, but misses everybody and still spins. The leader in this one here at the moment is 66. That is Charles Cockery. He just loses the lead at the moment. That's Lachlan McLean has got past him. Then we go back to Simon, Peter Knight there as well. Megan Malloy. Then we go to Graham Morris. Mark Henderson gets into the back of Morris, sends him into the infield. Just behind Henderson at the moment, we've got Jamie Lott. Then we go back to Scott Ashton, Simon Elliott, and Samuel Bennett Cathro. Corkery goes high. I thought he was going to come down across here on Paul Simon, but Simon manages to get past. Peter Knight starting to move into this battle now as well. He currently sits in that third spot. So Simon leads them around in the Toyota Sora. Peter Knight looks for the inside line. He gets past Corkery. Megan Malloy manages to sneak through there as well after that big spin in lap number one, car number 47 there. He manages to sneak through as well. That's Samuel Bennett Cathro. Oh, big contact down there. Car number 52 again. No surprises there. Graham Morris, he gets served up. Coming into turn four. So your top three at the moment, Simon, Peter Knight, Megan Malloy. Then we go back to, it looks like, Lachlan McLean. Cathro's there as well. Then Mark Henderson, Graham Morris, Jamie Lott there as well. They are almost the lap down. Keep an eye out for these three white and black Dunedin cars. They seem to be the ones causing all the carnage out there this evening, folks. Paul Simon's just going to tag onto the back of these three cars as he comes around. So are they going to serve up their Dunedin friend? Look at them all lined up on the main straight. They all go into each other. I don't think it worries them who they hit. They'll take each other out, these three. That's 52. Graham Morris, he gets pushed to the inside field. I tell you what, these guys from Dunedin putting on plenty of action here tonight at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. Corkery facing the other direction at the moment too. Mark Henderson, he may well have been responsible for that one, I think. He put a tag on him. But out in front at the moment, the South Island champion, he takes the white flag. That is Simon, he's leading. Megan Malloy up into second place. Peter Knight giving Graham Morris a bit of a hand around there. He's still nudging and puts him into the wall. Peter Knight does. This is Peter Knight, old school style, folks. Checkered flag is out. Car 7 takes race to win here at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. Megan Malloy just in behind him. Still plenty of banging on the wall there. Peter Knight still pushing Graham Morris all the way down on the main straight. Checkered flag is out. Couldn't tell you who got third place. I've got no idea. There was cars scattered all over the place. That's the sort of street stock racing we like to see. Great to see Peter Knight getting into these Dunedin boys, teaching them a lesson. I'm sure race number three this afternoon for these guys will be just as exciting. There'll be plenty of payback to come. Modified sprints are up next, folks. Stick around. Okay, folks, modified sprints out on track for their second race of the evening. Leading them out, car number 43, Chris Sharp. Sponsored by Transport Engineering Southland Creation Signs and Sivri T-Lines up alongside 99 George Phillips in the Green Cleanways Southern Mechanical Machine. And behind them, car number 84, Jason McMullen and Darcy Hewitt, car 11. Then we go back to race one winner, Tony Jones, car 23. Kobe Morrison and Tim Wilson at the back of the field in car number 18, sponsored by Waipunamu and Waimea Contracting. Track just a little bit slick at the moment for these guys, because we are just having to try and keep the water in the track tonight. It's held up very, very well so far. We must say a big thank you to Ewan and Dean Shearing and also Lloyd Phillips. They were here at the break of dawn this morning, tearing this track apart, regrading it, watering it, rollering it, you name it. Sharp leads them around, ready for a start here at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. Sharp's away. George Phillips goes to the outside. Then we've got McMullen. He's all over the back of Sharp as well. Hewitt, oh, there's going to be a rollover. Big one there. George Phillips tags the back of Chris Sharp. He went into turn one and two fairly hot. Nailed the back of car number 43. And over he went. That's the problem, folks. These things here touch wheels. That there is the end result. Just having a look at the Cando Fishing replay on the monitor up here in the control tower. And that's pretty much what it was. Phillips was just carrying too much speed coming out of turn two. He went into the back tyre of car 43, which was Chris Sharp. And over he went. Just had to hold on for the ride. So just a wee bit hot coming out of turn two on a slick track. And that is the result. So hopefully young George Phillips is all right. It's just his first season in this car, so might knock the confidence just a little bit. But it was a good battle at the front between Sharp, McMullen and Phillips. Just watching the replay there, and yeah, Phillips was just a wee bit tight there. McMullen and Sharp certainly had the line. He clipped the back of Sharp's car, over he went. Big thank you to the team at the pits and also Cando Fishing for supplying the monitor up here in the control tower so I can see those replays and let you guys know exactly what went on. Ready for a restart. Chris Sharp leads them around. We're away and racing. Chris Sharp, Jason McMullen, just like it was at the start of this one here. They're battling it out at the front. Then we go back to Darcy Hewitt, Jones, Kobe Morrison and Wilson at the rear of the field. Look at McMullen. He's all over the back of Chris Sharp there. At the moment, Sharp sits down nice and low. He's going to make McMullen work for it. He's going to go on a wee bit wide. McMullen's going to have a wee dive underneath. Manages to get the job done. Sharp may have made the mistake there of opening the door for him, but he comes back down the inside. It's a drag race on the back straight between Sharp and McMullen. Sharp sticks his nose under. He takes the lead back again. McMullen goes wide. Oh, almost contact on the main straight. Sharp decides to let McMullen slip back through again. Sharp very, very quick out of turn two though. McMullen, he matches that speed. So Chris Sharp falls back to second. Then we go back to Darcy Hewitt, Tony Jones, Kobe Morrison having a good run this time. And also Wilson at the back of the field. But I tell you what, Wilson seems to be getting the hang of this car as well. He's really battling it out with these boys at the back. Kobe Morrison gets a little bit loose coming out of turn two. Gives Wilson the opportunity to duck past him. Doesn't quite get it done. Out in front though, this was one of the top cars in Christchurch. Jason McMullen's just bought it and bought it down here, and he had a win last night. And he's certainly going to be one of the cars to beat when these other big guns return. He's looking pretty racy here tonight. Second place, Chris Sharp at the moment in the TES sponsored machine. Then we go back to Darcy Hewitt, Tony Jones, Kobe Morrison, Tim Wilson there. He's really starting to come to grips on with car 18. That was McMullen's old car. McMullen almost looked like he was slowing a wee bit on the main straight, so I don't know if there's an issue there for 84. Looks like there is. He's going to pull to the infield. So Chris Sharp takes over the lead of this one here, and he's got a good lead over Darcy Hewitt at the moment. Sharp won't believe his luck. He's managed to get the race lead back again with one more lap to go. Car 43 out in front. Back to Darcy Hewitt. Then we go back to Tony Jones. Race one winner. Kobe Morrison in that fourth spot. And Wilson there in fifth. In fact, Kobe Morrison got a wee bit untidy. Wilson took a brace of action. Checker flag is out, folks. Race two winner, Chris Sharp, car 43. Then we go back to Darcy Hewitt, Tony Jones, Kobe Morrison, and Tim Wilson settles for fifth spot. So there we go, folks. Deserve win. Give him a hand. Car number 43, Chris Sharp. Does a lot of work out here at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. Looks after the Facebook page. Does a lot of the promotions work for the team here. Good to see him get a race win. He'll be stoked with that one as well. Creativity Plus Production Saloons out on track. Heat number two of the evening for their Southland Championship. They'll just give him a few laps with this slick track there at the moment. We're going to keep the water on this track tonight. Reverse grid for this race here. Heat number two of the Southland Championship. Looks like Nikayla Livingston leads them around. Asher Clements to the outside of her in car 26. Then we go to Dave Horton, car 5. Jesse Stevens, car 72. Luke Oliver, car 68. Fitutawa, car 99 from Cromwell. 47 is Owen Osborne. Car number 4 had a good run in heat 1. That is Shay Davey. We go back to 52 from Cromwell, which is Jeff Friend. 25, race 1, a winner. He'll be hoping to get through the pack here. That is Tam Clements. And at the rear of the field there, he started from pole in race one. Car number 45, the Honda of Trevor N. May get a start this time around. They're starting to get into formation. Livingston and Clements lead them around. They're underway. Jesse Stevens steps out, goes right to the outside, tries to get around. Has to be a wee bit careful because the track's just been watered. We've seen cars come unstuck there before, but he manages to get the job done. Sticks on track. Asher Clemens, she gets stuck in the traffic there. She's gone from second back to fifth place, but it's Livingston, Stevens. Then we go back to Horton. Luke Oliver there and Clements. That's how they line up there at the moment. That's your top five. Jesse Stevens still liking that high line at the moment. Everyone else staying down fairly low. At Tam Clements starting to make a move as well. He's just managed to slip past car 52, which is Jeff Friends, who's picked himself up another spot. He's also gone around the outside of Shea Davey down there in 3 and 4. So he's starting to add some more points to his tally. Michaela Livingston doing a great job at the moment, though, on that bright green Honda Accord. She leads them around. Jesse Stevens in second place. Then we go back to Dave Horton. Luke Oliver, Fetutawa there as well. Look at Clements. Clements has gone right around the outside of this bunch. He's now up into sixth spot, so he's scoring some pretty valuable points at the moment. He's got Fetutawa in front of him. This is probably one of his main rivals for the Southland title. And he's just up in front of him. So a good drive by Clements so far. Plenty of laps still to go to make some ground up. Livingston still holds the lead at the moment. Stevens doing everything he can to get around the outside of her. Pushing pretty hard. Once again, he goes wide. Horton just sits in behind them. Oliver still in that third place. Stevens just pops a nose ahead as they head down the back straight. He may take over the lead from here. So Jesse Stevens looks like he's going to take the lead from Nikayla Livingston. Livingston holds the Honda Accord just on the inside line. Stevens got too much grunt. He goes around the outside. Livingston won't let him go then. Pokes her nose back under. Dave Horton's going to be sitting back in that third position, hoping that something happens up front there and he can make a move. But at the moment, looks like Stevens and Livingston still going head-to-head. Back there in that fourth position, Luke Oliver. Then we've got Fetutawa. And car 25, Tam Clements. Clements right on the back bumper now of Fetutawa. He'll be hoping he can pick himself up another position. They're both starting to catch Luke Oliver as well, so it's getting pretty exciting back there in fourth, fifth, and sixth at the moment. Last lap flag is out, though. He's running out of laps if he wants to do it. Last lap flag out. Livingston gets back underneath Stevens, so the lead has changed on the last lap. Livingston may hold Stevens out. Stevens looks to the outside. Livingston on the inside. Livingston just needs to keep the foot up and here on the main straight. Checkered flag's going to come out. Car number 12, it looks like. Oh, maybe not. I'll leave that one up to the judges. Stevens may have just got a nose ahead as he came over the line, but tell you what, Livingston absolutely put it in there. As he say, we'll leave it up to the judges. 72, we've heard. Very, very close finish indeed in heat two of the Southland Championship for the Creativity Plus Production Saloons. Dave Horton in third place here. 68 was Luke Oliver in fourth. Fetutawa fifth. And Tam Clements, he'll bag the points for sixth place. He'll be happy enough with that. Don't forget, folks, when we go to the final, it is winner takes all. Top point scorer will start from the front. A round of applause, folks. Jesse Stevens takes out heat number two for the Creativity Plus Production Saloons, their Southland Championship here tonight. I'm guessing these guys are probably running in, they can't be running in team smoke, because it looks like there is only the three of them out there. No sign of Andrew Watson in car number 95, the Irwin Tree Machine, which he's racing this afternoon. So just the three of them out there, car number 29, Shannon Knight, 21, Logan McNamara, and 8, Aaron Borthwick. Line up side by side, there is money up for grabs for the best stirrer. As we get underway, Borthwick gets a jump on Shannon Knight, but Shannon gets right into the side of him just in front of the control tower. Yep, I can feel them right underneath us, can't see us. Plenty of nudging going on there. You can see Shannon Knight making eye contact with them. And Borthwick, he's locked onto the front wheel of Shannon Knight, so those two cars are actually locked together. McNamara gets away. Borthwick manages to pull out of that one there. So Logan McNamara, he's off to a handy lead there at the moment. Shannon Knight manages to get going again. Borthwick gets right into the back of him. Knight won't do him any favours. Look at him, he's got the brakes hard on, you can see him. Wheels aren't wanting to go anywhere. He'll be holding up Borthwick and they'll be waiting for this man coming round. McNamara, they'll probably give him a serve as he goes past. Both on the infield now at the moment. McNamara is just going to drive around the outside of these two. So there he goes. Shannon Knight sees him go past and thinks, I'll have a piece of you, son. I'm going to chase you, so watch out for car 29. Oh, McNamara does it all by himself, but Knight, he'll probably still hit him anyway, but didn't have to. Shannon Knight leads them around. Aaron Borthwick here, want a little bit of payback. He goes wide. That track's fairly slick at the moment. Shannon Knight spins out on his own accord on the back straight, gets it back and straight again as Borthwick goes past them. Borthwick goes around as well. Different breed, some of these stock car drivers. On the main straight now, McNamara. They're going to take the cone out by the looks of it. Yep, so there's the cone for the infield stuck between these two heavyweight stock cars there. In fact, it's actually, I can see it, sitting within the rails of Logan McNamara's car. So he's got the cone. You can see it just on the inside there. Bright orange with reflective things on it. Yep, that's a road cone stuck in. There it is. He just managed to set the cone up on the infield. Just out of the infield, sorry. So Aaron Borthwick leads them around. Shannon Knight, Logan McNamara parked up in turn two. Not a whole lot of racing going on, unfortunately, folks. McNamara gets into the back of Shannon Knight. As Borthwick, he just circulates. McNamara and Knight locked together on the home straight. Borthwick will be seeing what's up in front of him. He'll just want to cruise around the outside of these guys, but I think Shannon Knight's got him in his sights. They both pop out. They want a piece of Borthwick. Nothing happening there. Borthwick just cruises around the outside there. It's all a bit of a procession at the moment, folks. Just the three of them out there. Borthwick and McNamara, they lock up on the main straight here now. Pretty light-hearted stuff here. Last lap flag is out for Aaron Borthwick. He's leading this one. Shannon Knight on the main straight there now as well. McNamara picks the cone up again, spits it back. Borthwick spits it out as well. I think that cone's a wee bit secondhand now. No use for a whole lot. Borthwick in beside McNamara. Shannon Knight coming down the back straight there. Borthwick, all he has to do is follow McNamara down the main straight. He decides to spin him around. Then McNamara tags him, but it's going to be Aaron Borthwick. He'll take out the win from Shannon Knight and Logan McNamara. Clerk of the course has pulled him in. Akara Lloyd Phillips certainly looking a bit battered and bruised after his trip around the North Island over the Christmas break. As they line up, one more lap and we'll be underway racing here. Race three for the afternoons in the saloon. Clark Brown leads them around. Trev Blacken behind him alongside 38, James Stronach. Graham Williamson, car number 21. Ewan Sheeran, 69. And joining the grid, car 47, Lloyd Phillips. We should get a start this time around, folks. Race three of the afternoon for the saloons here at the Rock FM. Riverside Speedway, Clark Brown leads them off. Trev Black has a bit of a dive, so does Graham Williamson. Stronach's there as well. Stronach takes the high line. Clark Brown just sits down nice and low. Graham Williamson slides into that third position. So he's picked himself up a spot. Stronach just shuts a door on Lloyd Phillips at the back of the field. So Phillips doesn't make any spots in this first lap at all. He's stuck at the back of the field. Brown leads him around. Then we go back to Black, Williamson, Ewan Sheeran. Phillips picks off Stronach now, so he's managed to pick himself up a spot there in the Hypermac. Graham Williamson pushing pretty hard on the back of Trev Black at the moment as they come down between 3 and 4 onto the main straight. Clark Brown, car 57, heads them around. Wee bit of contact between Black and Williamson. Rubbing's racing, absolutely nothing in it. Ewan Sheeran ready to pounce as well. He's now up into that fourth spot. Shearing sticks his nose in behind Graham Williamson as Williamson tries to get the push on Trev Black at the moment. Lloyd Phillips just in behind them. Then we go back to Stronach. Williamson still looking for a way around Black. Black making it as hard as possible for Williamson to have to get around him. Clark Brown leads them round for one more lap here in the saloons at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. Trev Black certainly not making it easy for Graham Williamson. Williamson decides just to slot in there. Good battle heading up now between, looks like Phillips and Shearing. Phillips just overturns. There's something on that car of Phillips. The handling's just not quite right tonight. That thing's usually on rails around here, but he seems to be struggling a wee bit. Graham Williamson heads to the outside this time of Trevor Black. Can't get it done on the outside. May have to have a look on the inside and sneak through under there. In the meantime, while that battle goes on for second and third, Clark Brown extends his lead by another car length on the main straight. One more lap ticked off for Clark Brown, car number 57. Trev Black and the big Chev Camaro pushing pretty hard behind him. Graham Williamson certainly not giving up though. Ewan Shearing's there, Lloyd Phillips is around. So as I say, the handling of 47, not ideal at all. Phillips goes to the back of the pack. Last lap, flag is out. One more to go for Clark Brown. Can he hold Trevor Black and Graham Williamson off? He's doing a good job at this stage. Only a couple of turns to go for Clark Brown. Graham Williamson has one more go at Trev Black. He heads to the outside. He's not going to get the job though. Done though. Clark Brown, he takes the checkered flag. Deserved win. Trev Black will settle for second. Graham Williamson third. Then we've got Ewan Sheeran, James Stronach and Lloyd Phillips at the back of the field. So good win, he was on pole, he led from start to finish. Clark Brown, he celebrates. Good win here tonight at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway for Brown. Give him a round of applause, folks, he drove that one well. Big thanks also to all the volunteers, officials, stewards, helpers, everyone who's made this meeting possible here at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. 2 days of racing, big commitment for people, but good bunch of folks here putting the meeting together. A lot of work goes on behind the scenes, so a big thank you to all involved. So you saloons out on track for their third race of the evening. Don't forget, folks, these guys here are the future of Speedway. And if you'd like your kids to be involved in the future of Speedway, they can race these from the age of 12 up to 16. Come along and see the youth grade rep. and he'll certainly point you in the right direction. Good we grade this one here, lead them out at the moment, car 16, Casey and Mitchell. She's on the front row of the grid just behind her. We've got Olivia Beck. Graham lines up beside car 15, Emma Phillips. Looks like we're ready for a start. We're away and racing. Mitchell leads them off. Phillips looks for the inside line. Then we go back to Beck, Graham, Garrick there as well. He's picked up two wins from two tonight. Then we've got Zane Zahuda. Looks like Jack Brown almost kissing that wall again. That's what put him on the infield last race. He's well back. He's been the man to beat all season, and he's well back in the pack at the moment. He's down there alongside Georgia Gordon, who's doing a good job there. Then we go back to Ladbroke. New racer, car 888, Jacob McIntyre, who's doing a good job on the wee start up there. He's having a crack around the outside. Ladbroke gets the job done, so he's obviously been allowed a pass now, which is good to see. And at the back of the field, car number 43, young Luke Malloy. So Phillips leads them around. It's all the girls at the front of the grid, at the front of the pack at the moment. Beck Graham sits in that second spot. Zahuda and Garrick just managed to get past Mitchell there. So she slipped back into fifth spot from starting this one on the front row of the grid. Phillips leads him around. Beck Graham, she's a good, hard young racer. Zane Zahuda tries to get down the inside of her, but I don't know if he's going to manage to get it done. Looks like he has. She just went a wee bit wide there. In fact, it looks like she might have went wide enough just to unsettle car 22, Jacob Garrick, but he'll come back. He's currently up in that fourth spot. Jack Brown starting to play into this one here now as well. He's shot to the inside, in fact, probably over the pole line there. Managed to get back on track. He's down in sixth. Good battle for the lead here now at the moment, though. Phillips and Zahuda. Zahuda almost kisses the wall. Manages to get down and hold on to that second spot. Beck Graham still currently third. Then we go back to Garrick, Mitchell and Brown. Brown once again over that pole line as he comes onto the main straight. I don't know whether that's where he's finding the drive or what's going on there. Bit of a handling issue perhaps. Then we go back to Gordon. Car 888, Jacob McIntyre doing a great job on the wee starlet. Then Luke Malloy and Ladbroke. Back to the front of the field now. Phillips doing a fantastic job at the moment. She's managing to hold out car 88. Of Zane Zahuda. He's tried to throw everything at her so far and hasn't managed to sneak past. Then we go back to Olivia Beck Graham. Garrick has a look on the outside of her. In fact, these guys sitting on the pole line are making pretty hard work for the guys on the outside. Jack Brown, he's now up into that fifth spot. He's picked himself up another spot. Less than a lap to go. Can Phillips do it? Car number 15, Emma Phillips, the Cleanway sponsored machine. She's still out in front at the moment. Looks like she's going to take the checkered flag and race three of the Youth Saloon. She's going to. Good win. She takes it out. Car number 15. Then we go back to Zahuda. Beck Graham. A good drive by Olivia Beck Graham. Solid night also by Jacob Garrick. Two wins in a fourth place. He'll be happy with that. But we've got to give it to car number 15. Good drive by Emma Phillips, sponsored by Cleanways and Southern Mechanical. She'll collect the checkered flag. I'm sure she'll be pretty stoked about that, folks. Give her a hand as she comes around. Certainly showed the boys how it's done. They're only kids, these guys. Good bunch of kids as well. They do a lot of work on the cars themselves. They help each other out when another car's got an issue. They're a real good bunch of kids and they love their racing. Congratulations, Emma Phillips, taking out race number three here tonight for the Youth Saloons. So three stocks out on track for heat number three of the afternoon for them. I have no idea what they are doing, but like race number three for them last night, I had no idea what they were doing either. I have been told that it's an absolute secret. I think they just do it to confuse the commentator here sometimes, but I've got no idea what they are doing. Whatever it is, it looks intriguing. Car number 66 out on track is Charles Corkery. Alongside him, car 43, Lachlan McLean. 47, Samuel Bennett Cathro. And alongside him, 52, is Graham Morris. 83, Megan Malloy. 19, Jamie Lott. 61 is Scott Ashton. Number 7, Paul Simon. 27, Peter Knight. And 34, Mark Henderson. Don't forget, this car of Henderson's is actually for sale, so if you want a real good solid street stock, go and see Mark in the pits. He's selling the Silver XR Falcon. Speedway Control Board official there, Mel Davison, just obviously telling the drivers what they need to be doing. I wish you'd tell the commentator what they're doing. I'm sure it's going to be entertaining, folks. No one's got any idea what's going on. And she high jumps the gate. Well done, Mel. Ready for a start. Race number 3 for street stocks. All nose first into the wall on the main straight. What's going to happen here, folks? It's an impressive looking sight. We're away in racing. Megan Malloy gets out first, and off we go. There's cars facing all directions. There's cars just... Car number 52, I don't know whether he's got reverse or not. That's Graham Morris. He's just parked against the wall doing a burnout. That was impressive. That was entertaining. But we're away in racing, and Megan Malloy is out in front at the moment. Peter Knight just in behind her. Then we go back to Lachlan McLean in third, who's side-by-side with Samuel Bennett Cathro. That's your top four at the moment. Then we go to car number 19, which is Jamie Lott, Paul Simon, Mark Henderson there as well. Red lights are on. Megan Malloy hasn't seen the red light yet by the looks of it.
They'll turn around.
I'm sure they're doing this just to play with my mind. Red light off, cars in a totally different direction. And it's about now that I've got no idea who's leading the race. Thanks, Mel. No idea who's leading the race, but in this pile of cars coming onto the main straight, I can tell you that that is car number 52, Graham Morrison behind him, 61, Scott Ashton, Paul Simon there as well. Then we go back to Megan Malloy. Oh, good nudge there on car 43. Gets a couple of wheels up off the ground. Not quite as impressive as Jackson Lovelady last night. Red flag out again. And round the other way we go again. So Mark Henderson now leads from Peter Nye, car number 47, Samuel Bennett Cathro. Then we go back to car number 19. Which is Jamie Lott, Paul Simon there as well, Megan Malloy, 61, is Scott Ashton. That's how they line up at the moment. Peter Knight getting in behind. Mark Henderson gives him a bit of a nudge on the back straight. Good to see Peter Knight dishing out a little bit of punishment this afternoon at the Rock FM Riverside Speedway. Car number 43 parked up against the wall there. That's Lachlan McLean. Seems like the Dunedin boys are certainly presenting us with a bit of contact this afternoon. Bennett Cathro, he tries to get away. Our red light again. Hope you're enjoying this, folks, more than I'm enjoying commentating it. I've got no idea who is placed where. Maybe the red light is legit this time.
Down by you.
Down So car number 43, Lachlan McLean, there's an issue there. We'll just tow him out of the wall and no doubt we'll be underway again. What direction, I have no idea. I have no idea how we even count the laps in this race, to be fair. So I've just been told on the lap counter that we've actually only completed two laps. Two full complete laps. Hope it's not a 20 lapper. Round we go, the opposite direction once again. Wonder how the guys go actually setting their cars up for this one. So I'm just going to pick a car, number 83, Megan Malloy. She's leading this one here. I'll just choose her because she's the only female in the field. Car number 61, Scott Ashton. He can be second place at the moment, and Mark Henderson can be third. Car number 52 into the back of 19. That's Graham Morris on Jamie Lott. Peter Knight ducks down the inside of car 66, Charles Cockery. 47, Samuel Bennett-Cathro in the big Falcon wagon there. Bit of smoke starting to bellow out the back of that at the moment. Red light again. So I'm still going to make Megan Malloy the race leader, just because I can. She's car number 83 leading this one here from car 61, Scott Ashton. Peter Knight looking pretty racy right around the outside of turn four there. Car 52 coming in at pace into the back of car 47. That's Samuel Bennett-Cathro. Oh, Paul Simon gets a massive nudge in the back end from Mark Henderson. He lines him up and absolutely drills him. Cockerton gets a bit of a nudge as well. Looks like a bit of a rut in that turn there at the moment. White flag is out. We've got one more lap to go, so long as there's not another red light. There should be a red light because Cockerton's not exactly parked in the best position to be parked in. I don't know if I'd like to be parked there, folks. Checkered flag is out though. Looks like car 61 has been given the win. Scott Ashton from Dunedin. I would have given it to Megan Malloy. So there we go, folks. I've got no idea who placed where. I don't think any of you were too worried. They're a different breed, these street stock drivers, aren't they? There we go, folks. Race number three for the afternoon for the street stock. Stick around in just a moment. The final race of the day for the modified sprints. Okay, folks, hopefully Mel has got that change in direction thing out of her system and we don't do that again with the modified sprints. That could be interesting. Modified Sprints out on track at the moment. Car number 84. He's been quick all weekend. That is Jason McMullen, sponsored by K&D Automotive. Car number 6 will line up outside him. That is Kobe Morrison, the Riverton Freight Milne Transport Machine. Race 2 winner, car number 43, Chris Sharp, sponsored by Transport Engineering, Southland Creation Signs and Sivrites. Car number 23, race 1 winner, Tony Jones, sponsored by Grant Auto Electrical, Singleton Signs and Speedmart. Then we go back to the back of the grid. Car number 11, Darcy Hewitt, K&D Automotive and X-Factor Cars are his sponsor. And a new driver here this weekend, car number 18, Tim Wilson, who did very, very well in that second heat of the Modified Sprints. He is sponsored by Waipunamu and Waimea Contracting. Underway, look at McMullen. Gets off to a good start. So does Jones on the outside. Chris Sharp gets stuck in behind Kobe Morrison. He won't want to be sitting there for too long with these two guns out in front. In fact, look at Jones. He goes right around the outside of McMullen. Makes it look like easy work on that high line at the moment. They're side by side. McMullen overcooks it. And I tell you what, there was a flag marshal who was very, very lucky standing in there. Very lucky indeed. Heart was in my mouth for a moment. Not as bad as what his would have been, I don't imagine. But McMullen on the infield. Jones out in front at the moment. Second place goes back to Chris Sharp. Then it's Darcy Hewitt sits in third. Car number 18, Tim Wilson in fourth place, and Kobe Morrison, obviously issues with car number 6 yet again at the rear of the field. Jones has looked pretty sharp all day, and he's making every post a winner at the moment. Chris Sharp a wee bit loose coming out of turn 3, but he's starting to chase Jones at the moment. He'll be pushing pretty hard. He'd like to pick up a couple of wins tonight. Looks like he might just be catching Jones too as they head down between 3 and 4. Jones still out in front from Sharp. Then we go back to Darcy Hewitt, the K&D Automotive machine. I tell you what, Wilson's doing a fantastic job in that fourth place. He's not letting the field away from him in just his fourth race in one of these cars. He was a street stock driver. He's taken to these modified sprints like a duck to water. Jones heads him around. He's just in front still. Look at Chris Sharp, though. Sharp looking very, very quick indeed. Half a dozen lengths between them. Jones just seems to be a little bit faster off the corner. Chris Sharp faster heading into the corners. Not much between the two of them at the moment as they head down the main straight. Sharp heads the outside line, cuts down nice and low. Watch Jones, he seems to have a little bit more grunt as they come off the corner. Picks himself up another length with Sharp in second place. Back we go to Hewitt. Wilson pushing this car hard now as well. He's starting to close that gap between himself and Darcy Hewitt. Still no change up front though. It's Jones out in front. Chris Sharp half a car length in it. Sharp decides to go wide. He's trying to be look for a wee bit of drive out in the thick stuff. Seems to be working for him as he closes the gap between him and Jones. He heads to the outside. Checkered flag is out. Don't think there was a white flag. Straight checkered. Tony Jones takes it out from Chris Sharp. Darcy Hewitt, he'll finish third. Wilson in fourth place and Kobe Morrison, he will settle for fifth. Obviously issues there for Kobe Morrison. But congratulations, Tony Jones. He takes race number 3 for the modified sprints. 2 wins today for Jones. He'll be happy with that. Bit of a scare for the official in the infield there, and a bit of a scare for Jason McMullen as well, I'd say. Might be a quick break while we have a change of underwear for that official. Stick around, folks, just a moment. Heat number 3. We've got Creativity Plus Production Saloon Southland Championship. Okay, folks, final and feature race here of the Production Saloon Southland Championship. Don't forget the big feature still to come for the Super Saloons a little bit later on in the evening. Leading them out, obviously, top on points at the moment, car number 68, Luke Oliver. He'll start from the front row of the grid alongside car number 5, which is Dave Horton. Car number 25, he's picked himself up a win here tonight. He got 6th in the last heat. That is Tam Clements. He'll start alongside 99 Fetutawa from Cromwell. Car number 12 is Nikayla Livingston, the wee green Honda Accord. 72, Jesse Stevens picked up a win in a race 2 this afternoon. Then we go back to 26, which is Asher Clements. 52 from Cromwell, Jeff Friend. Car number 4, Shay Davey. That's how they'll line up. This is the final of the Southland Championships for the Creativity Plus Production Saloons. It is winner takes all, folks. Keep an eye on Clements and Tower starting in the second row. Underway. Jesse Stevens jumps wide. He goes right to the outside, tries to drive around them on a slick track. I don't know if it's going to pay off or not. Got very, very close to that wall. It's Horton who gets away at the moment, though. Tower goes around the outside. Clements to the inside. Oliver's in the middle of that one there. Stevens just sits in behind them. Then we go back to car number 12, which is Livingston. Gets a little bit loose coming through 3 and 4. At the moment, it's a drag race on the main straight, though. Tam Clements and Horton. Clements looks for the inside line. Gets the job done. He's managed to sneak underneath Horton. So Tam Clements takes the lead in the final of the Southland Championship for Production Saloons. Horton to the outside, then we go back to Luke Oliver. Jesse Stevens still doing a lot of hard work in that Mitzi out wide. Tower on the inside line, then we go back to Livingston. Asher Clements there as well. Shay Davies, car number 4. Then back to Jeff Friend, Trevor Uren there, and Osborne at the rear of the field. Look at the lead at the moment that Tam Clements is building over this field, ladies and gentlemen. Just a young guy, he dominated race 1. And he's built up a good lead here at the moment in the grand final of the Production Saloon Southland Championship. Horton there, car number 5, the Honda Prelude. He's starting to battle it out now with Luke Oliver. Stevens still sitting on that wide line trying to do what he can to get around. Looks almost to be going too high in the Mitzi. May need to come down just slightly. He's currently holding that fourth position. Then we go back to 99, which is Fetu Tawa, the Subaru, Livingston, Davies, and Clements. No doubt about it though, car 25, the Invercargill Tractor Servicing, Toyota Celica, leads them around. Got a handy lead at the moment over Horton, he's in second place. Half a dozen car lengths ahead of Luke Oliver in third. That's how they line up at the moment here in the final of the Southland Championship. Just looking out the window, I can see his father, Steve, telling him to go faster. I think he's going as fast as he can. He's holding that lead. Bit of lap traffic up in front of him. He's got Osborne just ahead of him. I'm sure he'll head round the outside of him. Heads to the outside of the track. Osborne looks like he's just going to let him through. Round goes Clements in that Toyota Celica. He's got a handy lead now over Horton. Positions haven't changed. Stevens decided to come off the high line. He's down there in fourth place just behind Luke Oliver. Then we go back to Tawa. Livingston doing a good job in that fifth place. Then we go back to Shay Davey. Asher Clements there as well. One more lap ticked off for car number 25, Tam Clements. He can almost smell this Southland Championship at the moment. He's done everything right tonight so far. He's in control of this one here, still holding a good lead in this Toyota Celica. A couple of lap cars up in front of him in form of Trevor Uren and 52, Jeff Friend. Starting to extend the gap over Horton back there in second place. Bit of lap traffic there for Luke Oliver, starting to play into the hands of Jesse Stevens. Stevens goes to the outside of Oliver. That's your battle for second and third spot. Oliver's up in the middle there. Stevens very, very high indeed. That's where he sat most of the race. Can he get round the outside of Oliver? Oliver's got that inside line. He's making it hard for Stevens. Stevens may be a wee bit too high up. Fidutawa stuck between those guys and that lap traffic at the moment as well. Looks like another lap ticked off though for car number 25, Tam Clements. He goes around the outside of Trevor in at the moment. Dave Horton may have just clawed back another couple of car lengths, but still a decent lead there for Clements at the moment with that lap traffic between the two of them. Clements comes around. Manages to get around Trevor Uren. Horton manages to get around car 52. Jeff Friend, you're in between the two of them. Back in third spot, Oliver still battling it out with Stevens. Fedu Towers managed to get past Osborne. He's currently up in fifth spot. Another lap down for Tam Clements leading this one here. Horton starting to find a little bit of speed late in this race. Still, Trevor, you're in between the two cars, though. He certainly closed that gap. Clements will be hoping that Urin can just hold him up slightly. Looks like a white flag is going to come out, though. One more lap to go in the Southland Championship. Can Tam Clements do it? Horton manages to get past Urin. There's nobody between the two of them at the moment, but Clements has got a very, very handy lead. One more turn to go. Car 25, Tam Clements. He celebrated his birthday this week. He's also going to celebrate winning the Southland Championship. The Creativity Plus Production Saloons. Second place goes to Horton. Then we go back to Luke Oliver, Jesse Stevens, and Fetu Tawa. So there it is, folks. We crown a new Southland champion. Tam Clements will be absolutely stoked. The Invercargill Tractor Servicing and Repairs sponsored Toyota Celica. Give him a round of applause, folks. So folks, final race of the evening is going to be stock cars, and I can tell you that car number 8, usually driven by Aaron Borthwick, is going to be driven by Arnie Tahuta, who usually races in the street stocks here. This is his first go in a heavyweight stock car, so they're just going to give him a couple of laps just to get the hang of the car because he's never driven it before. And then it'll be a three-car battle between Arnie Tahuta, Shannon Knight, and Logan McNamara. Once the green flag drops, it'll be all go. So Tahuta, McNamara, and Shannon Knight, just the three cars in this one here. Looks like we're underway. Tahuta gets a bit of a welcoming snot from Logan McNamara. Shannon Knight decides to do it backwards and then park in front of Logan McNamara. So he takes a massive shot to the side. McNamara drives away. Knight's back underway again. Tahuta, he's at the other end of the field. He'll be thinking this stock car caper's pretty easy at the moment. He's getting up nice and high there in car number 8. Looks like an absolute natural in one of these cars. As he just drives on by McNamara and Shannon Knight, who are still busy beating each other up in the infield. So Tahuta leads this one here from Shannon Knight, McNamara in that third spot. Hopefully they bunch up a wee bit soon and show us a little bit of action. Arnie Tahuta really driving this machine fairly well. I think Aaron Borthwick will be pretty impressed with how he's handling car number 8 at the moment. Of course, he certainly knows how to pedal that car number 37 in the street stocks as well, so he's a good driver. Shannon Knight's chasing him down, though. Shannon will be keen as mustard to put a decent hit on him, just so that he remembers his first ever race out here in a street stock. Shannon Knight measures him up. I'm thinking contact's not too far away. They're on the main straight. Knight's right in behind him. I think Shannon let him off fairly lightly there. He's going to pin him against the wall. No, can't quite do it. Tahuta decides to pull out of it. Knight pushes him out to the wall. Tahuta breaks. I think Knight was going to try and put him up on his side. So Shannon Knight now leads this one here from Arnie Tahuta. Then back to Logan McNamara. What's Shannon Knight up to? He's going to have another crack at Tahuta. Tahuta saying, no, you don't, son. Shannon sits and waits. Tahuta goes around the outside. Knight measures him up into the wall. Oh, Tahuta would have felt that one. That was a big hit. Shannon Knight goes into it as well. Tahuta's going to dish out a bit of his own medicine now, though. He's into the back of Shannon Knight. Logan McNamara, he's down the other end of the track at the moment. Knight's just waiting for Tahuta to go to the inside or the outside, and then I think he's going to measure him up and drill him. Nope, Knight's away. So, white flag is out. Not sure who that was presented to, whether it was Shannon Knight or whether it was Arnie Tahuta. I don't think it really matters. One more to go at the Rock Riverside Speedway. Look at this. Knight is waiting for Tahuta. What's he got for him with one turn to go? They both slow down side by side. This could be one of the slowest stock car finishes of all time. Tahuta stops. Knight doesn't manage to get a hit on him. Checkered flag is out. Shannon Knight takes it from Arnie Tahuta. Logan McNamara third. That is it, folks. I hope you've enjoyed your Saturday evening here at the Rock FM or Riverside Speedway. And if you came out last night, thanks for coming out and supporting the team here at the Riverside Raceway. Don't forget, next meeting in a couple of weeks' time, Saturday the 13th of February, the ITM Modified Sprints. Promises to be an absolutely fantastic meeting. 3 p.m. kickoff. Gates will open at 1. We will see you then. Have a safe trip home. Thanks for coming out. Hope you've enjoyed the racing, and we'll catch you next time.